my first aim writing this book, it was very simple, and it is related with your last part of your speech. I mean, I live in China for 10 years, almost for 10 years. And when I was writing the book, it was like I realized that I saw the beginning of this process, that I don't think it's progress, to be clear. Or at least it's not a progress in the way it is developed, of course. Because if we talk about the technology and all the works affair that I try to explain in the book, it's not a progress, of course. So because in China, everything was proceeding really quickly. And I just realized when I was writing the book that I lived this process that was very fast. At the beginning, we don't understand what was happening. WeChat, for example, at the beginning was just a messaging app to keep in touch with Chinese friends. And we Western people, we laugh when we saw Chinese people use the vocal message, for example. Then every one of us was using vocal message. But then, day by day, WeChat became essential for living in China, not just for friendship, but also to buy, to book hospital examination, to fulfill a lot of bureaucratic stuff. But when I came back in Italy, I saw that a lot of Western media wrote articles about this Chinese technological process, using every time terms as dystopia, disturbing, and to me, it was really strange because a lot of things that I saw in China, I saw it also in the Western country. I mean, of course, for example, Facebook for a lot of years tried to understand the WeChat business model. And so, first of all, this is a really change in our point of view of the world because we were used to see the innovation process in the Western countries. And now it seems that it came from China. Of course, Facebook doesn't want to do something like WeChat. It's like a business model, okay? The interest of Zuckerberg about this. But then, for example, the surveillance system. Okay, Zuboff wrote the surveillance capitalist, but she is a liberal, so she thinks that surveillance capitalism could be ruled by capitalism. To me, it's not it's not so. It's a form of capitalism. It uses the same extractions and the same process of capitalism. Is an adaptation of capitalism thanks to the digitalization of the society. And then, especially with social credit system, to me was very strange, because, for example, the social credit about a business company or business, it's not different from a lot of social credit system in the Western country, for example, the FICO in United States. There are something similar also in Germany. The title of book, in fact, that is Red Mirror, is because it's related to Black Mirror, the TV series, no? Because a lot of media wrote about social credit system connected to the nosedive, that is an episode of Black Mirror, in which everyone rate the other with the mobile phone. But to me, it exaggerated this kind of vision of what's happening in China. And about, for example, the video cameras. In Italy, for example, I don't know in France, but the Italian cities are not different from Chinese ones in terms of video camera and surveillance system. I would like also to explore the Chinese people's reaction to this kind of technology process. Because I think in the Western country, we used to consider Chinese people, yes, people that accept everything, the Communist Party. And I would also try to explain that China is not the Communist Party, or at least is not only the Communist Party. There are hundreds of China, thousands of China. We're not the same, okay? It's different, the technology process. We are a democracy in some way. We can have a relation with authority that is completely different from what happens in China. But we are, as Chinese can could say, we are under the same sky, the sky of capitalism. Okay, this is another thing I want to clarify in the book. Okay, China has a different political system, but is completely engaged in the global market system. So it's not different what happens in China from what happens to us in terms of data collection, for example.